Ukraine's newly acquired M39 rockets, manufactured in the United States, possess the capability to incapacitate entire helicopter units on airfields and penetrate supply convoys and air defense systems. However, they fall short in effectively neutralizing heavily armored combat vehicles due to their warhead dispersing numerous small submunitions, each lacking the required potency to inflict significant damage on tanks. The M39 Army Tactical Missile System is a sizable ballistic missile, weighing 2 tons and spanning 13 feet, featuring a solid rocket engine and a warhead containing 950 M74 submunitions. Fired from either a tracked M270 or wheeled high mobility artillery rocket system launcher, this missile, dating back to the 1990s, boasts a range of up to 100 miles, guided by inertial systems. The US Army possesses a stockpile of M39s, many of which have reached or are nearing expiration. Recently, the Biden administration quietly dispatched an undisclosed quantity of these aged rockets to Ukraine, presumably after inspecting their solid rocket motors. In a recent operation, 3 Ukrainian Army HIMARS launched one M39 each at an airfield near Berdyansk, located in Russian-occupied Ukraine. These rockets bypassed Russian air defenses, scattering nearly 3,000 M74 submunitions across the airfield's northern section, resulting in the destruction of Russian Air Force Mil Mi-24 and Kamov K-52 attack helicopters stationed there. Ukrainian claims assert the elimination of 9 helicopters, with analysts confirming the destruction of up to 6. Regardless, it constituted a significant blow in Russia's 21-month campaign against Ukraine, described as one of the most serious strikes of all time by the Russian Telegram channel, Fighter Bomber. The Mi-39, equipped with 1-pound M74 submunitions made of steel and tungsten, excels in targeting soft area-based objectives. Upon impact and detonation, each grenade fragments into a multitude of high-velocity steel pieces, effectively engaging targets such as truck tires, missile rounds, lightly armored vehicles, and radar antennas. However, it's emphasized that the M39 is not an effective weapon against armored vehicles, as it lacks the necessary potency. While a barrage of M74s might inflict damage on a tank's optics, and, with some luck, penetrate the thin armor on the hull, it shouldn't be relied upon to halt an armored assault, particularly if the tanks are sealed and dispersed. In the late 1990s, the US Army developed an updated ATACMS missile variant, intended to carry 13 guided anti-tank munitions. Although this project was ultimately cancelled for cost-saving reasons, it wasn't due to other ATACMS variants suddenly becoming more proficient at tank destruction. The Biden administration has made it clear that the United States intends to supply Ukraine with ATACMS munitions without compromising its military readiness. This implies that expired or nearly expired M39Es are eligible for transfer, along with older M48, equipped with 500-pound unitary warheads. However, the new M57S will remain in the possession of US forces. Between the M39S and M48S, Ukraine gains a range of options for its roughly 60 M270 and HIMARS launchers. The M39's M74 submunitions are well suited for clearing Russian airfields and logistical facilities, while the M48, with its penetrating warhead, borrowed from the Harpoon anti-ship missile, can destroy fortified bunkers and structures. In the event of a tank assault, alternative munitions might be preferable for Ukrainian forces.